My name is Ashanafe Washington. And today we're going to be covering a topic that's important, is black women empowerment. And we're going to make a panel, a series of questions. And we're going to ask two black women. We're going to ask my mom and his mom. And then we're going to put the quotes that we pulled from the interview onto windshield wipers. And yeah, this will be very interesting.
Thank you.
In movies that they usually have black women in them, they usually take the roles of like gold diggers, baby mamas, mean mom or family members, or black Barbies. Why does big pictures like outwardly hand these roles out to them first?
Well, a lot of times they take the roles because of the pay, the fame, to be on television. But we are having a turnaround with more positive black women roles, like lawyers, doctors. Mm-hmm. I think it's turning around from us being maids and what else they have us doing, maids and prostitutes and pimps.
Right. Okay, now my question is kind of like Ashanafe's a little bit. I said, how do you feel about black women being portrayed as a bad image and exposing their bodies in music videos?
Well, really, to that, I feel that it's low class, bad taste, because you don't have to show your body in order to perform, or you don't have to show your body
to gain attention.
Yeah. Use your mind.
I like that. And another thing, going off of what Sade had asked, our young black females are watching these music videos and, like, you know, getting hyped off of them, and those are their role models. How do you feel that? How does that make you feel that our young women are portraying these females, and those people that are in those music videos aren't even like that? They just do it just to be famous, just to have money.
Like, how do you feel about thinking that our next generation could be like?
Well, I really feel sorry for our next generation, because it's just so much peer pressure to be, as they call, cool. And with the music and the lyrics, killing, drugs, there's no positive message in any of the younger generation music. Our music, we had positive things that were taught to us when we were younger that our generation has not a clue.
And like the older generation, they have a lot of positive messages in their songs compared to now. We have like twisted messages, like,
yes, nothing but drugs, money, power, all the things that basically are sending our young youth and generation to jail to try to maintain those things that they think that's important.
Mm-hmm. So, what's your opinion on fragility? If you don't know what that is, fragility is where society makes black women seem like they're less of what they are and breaking them down, like making them feel like they're not as important as a white woman or a normal human being. How do you feel about that?
Well, basically, as being a black woman and being raised by a lot of black, positive, strong women in my life, fragility. Mm-hmm. And that was basically on
how society breaks down the black woman's image.
Okay, well, yeah, but true that if you are raised and you're around a lot of black positive women, you can't help but to be a strong black positive woman, like I'm trying to raise my daughter to be strong.
So you're just saying it's based off how you're raised. If you're raised strong, then all the bad things that are being said to you and thrown to you doesn't even affect you
because you are mentally able to deal with it.
Right.
I like that a lot.
Thank you.
seen a movie like Black Panther with all the black and African women.
Wakanda forever.
And African women that have more and more powerful and stronger roles than just sex appeal. Do movies like that make you think that we're moving forward?
Movies like that make me think that our true story is being told. That's how I see us. As strong, as warriors, and as lovers of our people and where we're from. So I think it's a more accurate portrayal, even in its fiction.
That was a good answer.
Okay. My fourth question is, what's your opinion on fragility? And I have to explain it. But fragility is where society tries to break down the black woman's image and make them seem and look as if they're not worth as much as a white woman or something.
Well, first of all, the levels, the hierarchy that we have in this country of who is valuable and why they're valuable is wrong, and it's a mess anyway. Because women in general are placed lower than men, and then black women are placed lower than all of it, right? So the hierarchy itself needs to go away and be dissolved, because it's not accurate and it's not beneficial for us. But I do recognize, you know, there are things that I see, for instance, with the word and the use and the concept of ghetto. You take a black woman and you put her out here and something little and maybe a little showy or a little risque, and you put, you know, blue, she's got blue hair, right? And she's walking around and people will say, oh, she's ghetto. But then you take, you know, a Chloe and you give her blue hair and put her something small on, and it's fashion. It's different. It's unicorn. It's the everything but ghetto. So I do recognize that that is a thing. And I just need us to mature a bit. Humanity in general.
Yeah.
We just need to grow up as humans, especially in the United States and the West, where sometimes I think like teenagers, no offense, but we're like teenagers in the way that we think about things as Western culture. And I think that we need to appreciate the differences that we have. And I think that black women in general have a lot of creativity and soul, and we're just interesting. And it could just be that. It doesn't have to be less or lower or bad. It's different and beautiful.
Okay. That was a long answer, but it was nice though. It was nice. I think it's almost time to wrap this up. So one of my final questions would be, do you think that the whole black woman culture is just misunderstood, and that people should just seek more into learning and getting information instead of just creating opinions and diving right into conclusions and stuff like that, instead of just automatically assuming?
If we're gonna classify humans, if we're going to separate ourselves, if we're gonna separate ourselves from male and female, if we're gonna separate ourselves by races and by all these things, the best thing that you can do if you're not in your classification is to listen. Listen to the group that you're thinking about and that you're wanting to create opinion about. Listen, and listen with empathy. Listen and seek for understanding rather than seeking to make your opinion right.
Do you want me to do my last one?
Yeah.
Okay. So my last question is, what institutional and societal changes need to be made in order for black women to feel more accepted?
This is a hard question. This is a hard question for me. Because I have come up under revolutionaries. My mother, my family, the research I've chosen to immerse myself in. But I'm at a point where I think being an evolutionary is a lot more beneficial and important. And with that, I don't need us to be accepted. I need us to be independent. I seek for us to be able to support, build, and maintain our own things, and for those things to be sustainable. Unfortunately, not everybody is going to accept you. And that's just the reality of where we are currently. That might not be the case forever, but right now, some people aren't going to accept you. And I feel like they have that right, but that has absolutely nothing to do with how I feel about myself. So, lightweight, I don't need your acceptance.
Thanks to my mother and her mother and Mr. Griffin for putting all this together. And one of the most important things that I learned about this is that, first of all, everybody has a different life. Everybody has a different story. And to make sure that we give them people their opportunity to tell their story is very, very important. And that nobody or no amount of people should be able to tell another amount of people or somebody else that they're not good enough or they're not as good as them or anything like that, because that's just not right. And I don't condone that at all. I hate it. And you know, I love joning with my friends, but it's all for jokes. Joning on somebody and straight up making fun of them is two completely different things, and I don't like it at all. And if we can figure that out as a country and as a people and as a society, I feel like we can make our way up and not be anything like we are today. And I believe in every single one of y'all, all you kids listening, and all everybody, people around the world. And on to you.
Okay. I want to say thanks to Mr. Griffin, my mother, his mother, for actually making me think broader into the situation. His mom had some very wise words that I really took in. It just makes me think that black women are more powerful than I actually imagined them to be. We all have different stories that are waiting to be told. We all have different point of views, different concepts of things. I also, back when he was talking about the Jonah thing, I also see how we use the N-word to greet each other, but we shouldn't, because like it was made to put us down. But that also has a positive side, how black people and all can make such a negative thing into kind of a positive, how it's made to bring us down, but we use it to greet each other.
Right.
So I just learned more about the black minority and how we all are strong. We all have something that we're all good at. If we just get together and be united and share our stories more, then we'll get somewhere, most definitely. So that's what I learned.
Yep.
So
thank you, and
y'all chill.